Hi, and welcome to Oath Keepers Now. I'm Mike Chisholm. I'll be your host today. Oath Keepers is a nonpartisan organization consisting of active duty and retired military, law enforcement, EMTs, firemen, anyone who's basically sworn the oath to the Constitution, that is the U.S. Constitution, or who wishes to swear the oath to the Constitution. Tonight I have a few announcements. Then later in the program, I have a video that I shot a couple of weeks ago, which first of all, I like to apologize to those veterans that I haven't put it on the show sooner, but at times things get a little hard. This was on the burial on that Marine, Will Pretzer. It was a great, well, you'll see. First thing is, first announcement is we have a class called The Making of America, and that class, The Making of America, is held at the Marshall Public Library from noon to 1 o'clock, and the point of contact is Ron Clayson. Another constitutionally based class is by Mike Gregson, and that's also at Marshall Public Library. And that'll be from 1 p.m., stand corrected, from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. at night. And his name is, which I just said, Mike Gregson. There's something that's coming up I want to talk to you, everyone, about. And I like to ride my motorcycle, and many of us do, I guess, especially the veterans. There's a POW MIA rally, and it's, from what I understand, the annual show of all shows that will be held at Elko, Nevada. And that will be on February 17th of this year, of course, in a few days. And hopefully I'll be there so you can see my happy smiling mug. I'd like to encourage also, before I get into some of the footage I have from Marine Metzer, I went back up to the veterans home there on Alvin Rickering. I can never say that, but you know where I'm talking about. A drive. And we should have a lot more people up there. I mean, there is a lot now. But if you guys could take just 30 minutes out of your day, 30 minutes, what's 30 minutes? That's like half of the Price is Right, or maybe take an hour, the whole Price is Right show. I'm not knocking Price is Right, please. I don't need any lawsuits. I'm a poor man. But in any way, spend some time. If not at the veteran's home, do something. We need to get out there, and we need to do it soon. Our country is surely in great peril. Those of you that don't believe it, well, please give me a call or get a hold of me, and I'll be glad to sit down and listen to you and ask you, well, gee, why? I wonder why you think it's not in peril. Why you go to the grocery store and it's $7, almost $8 for a box of cereal that used to be this big and this tall and was $1.50, and now it's $8. So that has nothing to do with Oath Keepers, but in a way it does. Oath Keepers, our mission is to reach, teach, and inspire. And I'm trying to inspire the people out there to get out, get the message out that we need to get back to constitutional principles. Now, as for the Oath Keeper side, for all the Oath Keepers that are watching this throughout the state of Idaho, after I have this televised, I do put it on YouTube, so it does go on our national site. I have separated our state of Idaho in four regions. Region one is Pocatello and the southeast portion. Region two is Twin Falls and the western, southwestern portion. Region three is the Boise area, and region four is basically Coeur d'Alene on up north. Region 4's director is John Mackey. Region 3's director is Rick Donovan. And Region 1, well, that's me. I guess I'm everything for Region 1. If there's any Oath Keepers out there, excuse me, if there's any Oath Keepers out there that do know when, if anyone wants to step up to the plate and take on the responsibility of Region's 2 director, please give me a call at 208-226-6553. All right, well, since I've said that, I'd like to run the first video. It's a short couple of minute video, just as they prepped for the funeral for Marine Pretzer. I'm sorry, I keep on saying Metzer. I apologize, forgive me. So whenever we're ready, we can go ahead and run that, please. You know, that was a really, really cold day, and there was a lot of people there on their motorcycles. It was a great honor for Marine Will Pretzer. If you notice, the hearse, a very unique hearse, something that I had never seen before, honestly, and I was very taken by it. Someone took the time to go all the way down to Salt Lake City, Utah, and pick it up and bring it up here. From what I understand, Mr. Pretzer was a very, very well-liked Marine in this town. He touched many people's lives. I did speak to him once, very briefly, just in passing. I never really got to know the man. I wish I had now from everything I had heard about him. If we can go to the next video, please. That was a very, very moving moment. Just that Marine being placed in his coffin by those other Marines, sharply dressed, paying their last honors to this man. We have so many young men and women that have died and are dying and that will die. Often I see veterans that are being buried here locally in Pocatello that has maybe one or two people standing around. I don't know the story behind them. I'm not trying to demean anyone in any fashion. But my personal opinion is this, that every man or woman that dies for our country should be afforded such honor as these men has afforded Will Pretzer, Marine Sergeant Will Pretzer. Let's go to the next video, please. Thank you.
Members of the Pocatello Veterans Honor Guard, in behalf of the United States of America and the POW MIA, the American Legion Riders, and the Iowa National Guard, are here assembled to give a lasting proud tribute of respect to departed Marine Corps veteran. When the call of our country was heard, Will Pritchard answered. Selfish regard for cause of greater good. As a brave man, he marched away to find faith in his God, his country, and his flag. The red in our country's flag had been made redder still by his heroism. The white was dancing pure by the motives which impelled him. And in the starry field of our nation's glorious banner, the blue had been glorified by the service he has rendered the American ideals. Hooray, Bruce!
Almighty and merciful God. That was when they were burying the gentleman, again, Marine Pretzer. Sometimes it's hard for me to talk about these things. Just to be there when I was filming it, I tried to, when I was called to attention, try to stay as attention as possible, but I had the camera and I didn't want to disrespect our flag, which, later in the show, after one, I have one more video, but later in the show, I'm going to read you something that our Supreme Court Justice Ginsburg said. And this is after men and women are dying for our Constitution. sometimes it just amazes me where we're at in our country today. But this is why Oath Keepers was formed, so that we number in the thousands across the country and the world, far more than many people believe. Many are very clandestine, if that's a good word to use, in agencies, be it federal, state, local, that are very, very quiet about it, that have contacted various other members, like from the board of directors and even myself, that are concerned to step forward, but they're ready to step forward to defend the Constitution at all costs. But if you could run that last video, please, sir. Thank
you. If you are a veteran, please come to attention and a hand salute. All others, please place your hand over your heart. Officers, color guard, present, horror.
Rifle squad, port, arm. Aim. Fire. Aim. Fire. Aim. Fire. Present. Arm.
Hold up. Hurr.
Well, that was the conclusion of the funeral process in burying Marine Sergeant Pretzer. You know, I want to personally thank each and every individual that showed up at that gentleman, at that Marine's funeral. Not only those that participated in the honor guard, but those that just showed up. Took a few minutes out of their time in their day. How many of you out there take a minute of your time just to say, hey, thank you for being a vet, or thank you for serving our country? You know, you wouldn't be sitting on your couches, and I'm not knocking that because I sit on my couch a lot, as you can tell. But the truth is, we need to begin to put all our petty differences aside and begin to say, hey, we best get together and work as a fellow countrymen, or we're not going to have a country. Which brings me up to this, which angers me. Well, it upsets me. Anger, they might misconstrue that. But here's a Marine Sergeant Pretzer buried. And then I read this yesterday by one of our Chief Justices, Ginsburg. And I will read what I got. By Fred Brown Bill on February 4th, 2012, in the Constitutional Legal Watch. If you're wondering what causes the destruction of America, U.S. Supreme Court Justice Ruth Ginsburg may give part of that answer to that question. Al Haiti, I can't pronounce these Middle Eastern names, L-H-A-Y-A-T, so Al Haiti TV in Egypt, interviewed Justice Ginsburg, asking her for the advice she would give Egypt in writing a constitution for their country, for their newly formed country and their newly formed government. Her reply to this question gives insight into how she thinks, basically. Her thoughts and understandings of why and how she said it. She replied, I can't speak as to what the Egyptian experience should be, she said, because I am operating under the rather old constitution. The United States, in comparison to Egypt, is a very new nation. Yet we have the oldest constitution still enforced. A constitution that should be changed is basically what she said. I can't believe that, but you can look it up on the internet, and it came across, I believe, World News Daily. But, you know, there's so many things going on. It appears sometimes we're being overwhelmed. I feel I'm being overwhelmed. We have the economy to worry about. Of course, now everything's being pushed aside because here we are 10 months out or 8 months out, whatever it is, to 2012, of November 2012 election. And everybody's worrying about their elections. Well, we need to focus more on our economy, about our jobs for vets. One other thing I'd like to point out before I get to another point, which is somewhat off Oath Keepers, but it actually does pertain to Oath Keepers. We need to get those Oath Keepers that are out there now listening, we need to get them to start speaking to the younger generation, those that are just getting into college. And you all know we have a really big college here at Idaho State University. We need to get these young men and women to understand that our Constitution is not something that can be changed, or it's a flexible document, as some in higher offices, elected offices, have said in so many words. The Constitution is written in stone, and I believe divinely inspired, however you want to take that. We need to talk to these younger men and women, and in hopes to get with them. Now, on another matter, House Bill 410, Idaho House Bill 410, which basically calls for a myriad of changes where Pocatello here locally would be losing thousands of dollars. I spoke with Representative Jim Guthrie for quite some time yesterday as he was en route back to Boise State's the capital in Boise State. Being from Hawaii, I never had great about proper English. Nonetheless, he was on his way to the capital. He and I spoke, and there were some concerns, one of which, HB 410 was created by CenturyLink and the Idaho Cable Association. Not all stakeholders, which is we are a PEG, was involved. Basically, getting to the short of it, since I'm looking at my clock and I'm running out of time, and I actually should have done more time on this, and I apologize. we were told that by Representative Guthrie that instead of Pocatello losing around $80,000, that we may only be losing $30,000 to $35,000, and the other states may be losing a lot less, being that now that the cable company, I guess Cable One, and I'm assuming Cable One, so don't quote me on that, has decided to go ahead I guess curtail the losses, as they would say. As I was indicating, on House Bill 410, Representative Guthrie said no pay channels would be lost. Well, that's not really the case from what I've been told and from what I've done some research. What will happen is that channels such as this, where Oath Keepers is allowed to make our show and many other shows, and it doesn't matter if you're far left, far right, up, down, middle, in between. If you're an American, you're an American, in my opinion. But what will happen is we will not have the staffing available. It's like a friend of mine told me, it's like, well, here, we're going to go ahead and give you a car, but you're going to get, we can't give you the gas. But you got a really nice car, you got a really nice car, but we can't give you the gas. And I think that's a great analogy. And people, especially Oath Keepers out there throughout Idaho, I know we don't go that way, we're in the southeastern portion. You guys need to get out there, get with your friends, get with your family throughout the state of Idaho. Have them call their representatives, call their elected officials, be it state level, be it county level, be it local town level. You guys need to get this going and say, hey, it doesn't appear that House Bill 410 is something that's very good for us. In fact, it's very detrimental, meaning that one day I will no longer be able to do this show or all the other shows. Yeah, or maybe we will be, but instead of me doing it once a week or twice a week, we'll be able to do it once a month or maybe once every 6 months. You know, it's often... I often am very surprised at how funny things are where they put bills and they put bills forward and they make it look so grandiose that, oh man, this is so good for the people. Yet inside of the bill, in a little insidious, small, like page 750,000, and of course I'm being facetious, they'll have a little word or a little passage. This is why we need to be vigilant, and part of Oath Keepers is being vigilant. We need to help with House Bill 410. We need to call the representatives. We need to do everything we can to stop this. I'm going to check my notes here a quick second if there's one more thing I want to tell you. One thing that was told by me, that all cities was represented when the negotiations were ongoing for this House Bill 410, which has not yet passed, but it is in the House. That wasn't the case. Not all cities were represented on the PEG systems. So, as I said, and I'm being repetitive here, and I'm down to 1 minute, I just wanted to make sure that you guys understand the importance and the impact that you can have. If you just get out there and take the 30 seconds or minute or half hour or hour of your time and get involved in the community. You know, our community is what we have. If we can't get our petty differences aside, we won't have that community. Well, as I always say, God bless, good night, and for our republic.